They just get the playoff. Now Fitzpatrick. He'll get this into the hands of Antonio Gibson. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Fitzpatrick. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
He was trying to get that one out to his running back out of the backfield, but that one was read and timed perfectly, and they were able to break it up.
Second and 10. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Now a second down throw for Fitzpatrick. He's got it to Gibson. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 45-yard line. Now Fitzpatrick. His throw incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Fitzpatrick. Packer pressure, and down he goes. Third and long, Fitzpatrick following the sack. What can he and the gang come up with? Looking to throw. Fitzpatrick. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
First down, Fitzpatrick. Dancing to his left. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, not much there that time. And I think we were both wondering once he got out of the box whether he just throw the ball away and he winds up only picking up a yard or two.
Fitzpatrick throwing complete. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
First drive of the game. We did see this in practice, didn't we? Because they allowed us to stay and watch and see what their opening script would be, even though we don't know the exact play calls. That looks a lot like what we saw them execute, doesn't it?
It really does. And in practice, it wasn't about a lot of big shots on that opening drive. They wanted to put together a series of plays, sustain it. They've done that. The defense now on their heels a little.
That they are. And you know what else is happening now? They're gaining information. They're gaining knowledge about how the defense is planning on playing them. So not only are they being successful on this drive, they're filing things away for future drives in this game.
On first and 10, it's Gibson. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On second and 9, Fitzpatrick flushed out right. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
On third down, Fitzpatrick. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Aaron Stokes. And the Packers are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at the 20. Throwing to start the drive. Rodgers. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch. It's a big play there for Green Bay.
But they didn't ease into that drive right out of the turnover. They go for the big shot downfield and hit it. A lot of teams have that opportunity, but not every coach is going to green light that type of a play call. I love their aggressiveness.
We're scoreless after one. Back for the second quarter in Green Bay. It's the Packers in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Now it's Rodgers. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
To throw on second and 10, Rodgers. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They have to like what they've done defensively here at the outset of this drive. They forced a couple of incomplete passes, bring up a third and 10. Don't be surprised to bring a little pressure on this snap.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. Here's Rodgers to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Packers unable to pick up the first. And Washington will have it on the turnover on downs. Out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. To throw, Fitzpatrick. And looking for McLaurin, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And the Packers are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the wild bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. Scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. On the handoff, this is Dillon. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Rodgers gonna throw. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. He gets this to Devontae Adams. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Rodgers. Well, that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
That's a tough spot for a running back coming out of the backfield because you know he's got to look for the football. Knowing full well, he's got a man coming his way, full steam, and he broke that one up.
And again, it's Rodgers. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Down, Rodgers. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Montez Sweat. Give him the credit for the sack and a loss of 14 yards. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. From midfield, here's Rodgers. He hits Adams, complete.
Brilliant.
Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams, 50 yards, as his guys are on the board first here tonight. Connects on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Now it's Patterson. And they'll have good field position here as he's out of bounds up at about the 34-yard line. They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
Now a throw over the middle, and he's got it to start the drive. They'll come up on a second and four now from the 40-yard line. Fitzpatrick to throw it. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Kevin King with a pick. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Extra point up and good by Crosby. And that'll make the score 14-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And with him down two scores, you wonder if they might try and put something together, even if it's just to get into. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down near the 20-yard line. Well, we heard all week that they were going to put the football in the air a lot. The problem is that is now four interceptions, Charles, that he has thrown in this first half. How do you treat a situation? What do you say to your quarterback right now?
Boy, that's an interesting question, because a lot of it depends on the head coach and the people making the decisions. You have to know your quarterback and know if he's mentally tough enough to have a chance to turn it around. Or is he a guy that maybe you've seen enough and it's time to go to the backup? But right now what you're rooting for is your defense to help keep you in the game, to give him an opportunity to get back on track.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw is Rodgers. He's got the hook up to Lazard. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Here's first and goal, and gosh, points here. A chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. Rodgers now to throw. Toward the pylon, caught. And it's a Packers touchdown. It's Devontae Adams hauling it in from Aaron Rodgers. And the Packers will extend their lead here just before halftime. Crosby with the extra point, and that makes the score 21-0. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense, as they'll take over with just 13 seconds to go before the break. Complete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
I hate to say it, Charles, but the way that he has played in this first half, you just kind of hold your breath every time he drops back to pass.
Yeah, you might be holding your breath, but those guys on the defensive side of the ball, they've got big smiles on their faces. He's handing out picks like the people just leave the candy out.
And my goodness, another interception. Adrian Amos with a pick, and he will be brought down on what would be the final play of this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. And a short kick taken at about the 16.
I got money, take care of mass, to ride to the wheels, don't crash, and I hit one. favorite religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a tutor. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was gone home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chillin', click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real, about to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Trying to make a killer, stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling.
Normal feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling.
Hey, Belly, them ready? Yeah.
When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground.